In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. My dearly beloved in Christ, on October 13th, 1917, during the great miracle of the sun at Fatima, and Our Lady's last apparition there, the Blessed Mother appeared as Our Lady of Mount Carmel, dressed in the Carmelite habit and holding the grand scapular out to the world. Fatima scholars and historians asked Sister Lucia why Our Lady did that, and Sister Lucia responded, because Our Lady wants everyone to wear the scapular. It is a sign of consecration to her Immaculate Heart. In an interview with Sister Lucia back in 1950, a Carmelite priest asked her, "You mean if one did all of the things Our Lady requested, rosary, sacrifice, penance, but did not wear the scapular, would he be fulfilling what Our Lady asked for completely at Fatima?" And Sister Lucia responded, "He could not fulfill what the Blessed Mother asked for at Fatima if he refused to wear the scapular." And what a simple request it is, to wear a tiny piece of brown cloth as an act and proof of our love for and devotion to Mary. When we place that brown scapular upon ourselves, without saying one word, we are telling Our Lady over and over again, "I venerate thee, I love thee, I trust thee." And we tell her these things every moment of the day, simply by wearing the grand scapular. And God is never outdone in generosity. Our Heavenly Mother attached two great promises to this grand scapular. The first is this. In the year 1251, when Our Lady appeared to St. Simon Stock with the scapular, she told him, "Anyone who dies clothed in this shall not suffer eternal fire. It shall be a sign of salvation, a protection in danger, and a pledge of peace. And if wearing it they die, they shall be saved." In other words, the soul will be given the grace to persevere in the Christian way through the wearing of the scapular. A person cannot live a life of mortal sin, disobeying the Ten Commandments, and leading a hedonistic life of sinful pleasures and amusements, and say, "Well, I wore the brown scapular, so I have nothing to worry about. I will go to heaven as Our Lady promised." That is not true. To lead a willfully sinful life while trusting in the scapular promise is to commit a sin of presumption of God's mercy. When one wears the grand scapular, it must be understood to mean that one is striving earnestly to live up to all the Christian ideals, and not just thinking and choosing what one wants to obey. And by wearing the brown scapular, a person with God's grace is going to abhor sin and cringe at the thought of committing the slightest offense against the infinite majesty of God. The scapular is a protection. It's a shield against the devil. The devil loathes clients of Our Lady, and so he will flee from the soul wearing the grand scapular. Pope Pius XI warned the faithful, "Although it is very true that the Blessed Virgin loves all who love her, nevertheless, those who wish to have the Blessed Mother as a helper at the hour of death must in life merit such a signal favor by abstaining from sin and laboring in her honor." We are all victims of original sin. We are prone to do evil. Sin is alluring. Weak beings that we are, we fall, but Our Lady will give the grace of repentance during the final moments of one's life, even if they are persistently and habitually living a life of sin. And if we have not been faithful at times during our lives, that scapular will plead God's mercy for us on the day of judgment. There is an introit to a Mass of Our Lady. Remember, Blessed Virgin Mother of God, to speak well on our behalf before the Lord. And the second great scapular promise is known as the Sabbatine privilege. In order to gain the Sabbatine privilege, one must faithfully wear the scapular throughout life, observe chastity according to one's state in life, and recite the Holy Rosary daily. As St. Dominic reminds us, the Rosary and Scapular are inseparable. According to tradition, Pope John the 23rd, on March 3rd of the year 1322, issued a bull stating that observance of the conditions for the privilege would be released from purgatory on the first Saturday after their death. That is why very often images of Our Lady of Mount Carmel are depicted with souls in purgatory being released by her, grabbing the scapular that she is holding out to them. In fact, St. Faustina, in her diary, states that the souls in purgatory call Our Lady the Star of the Sea, because she brings them refreshment. And in that very diary from St. Faustina said that the souls in purgatory look forward to Saturday to the visit of Our Lady. And even if they will not be released to heaven, perhaps they were not fulfilling Our Lady's request, they still need to be in purgatory for a time, they're still happy that she came, because as we get refreshed on a hot summer day by standing at the shore of the ocean, and that ocean mist spreading us, cooling us, that is where Our Lady is called the Star of the Sea, to bring that refreshment to the holy souls in purgatory. St. Jose Maria Escrivá, the founder of Opus Dei, once counseled the members of Opus Dei how motherly is the Sabbatine privilege. And so we take comfort in these two great scapular promises. Aren't they incentive enough to wear the scapular? And it is not enough simply to put the scapular on ourselves. We must remind individuals that a person needs to be enrolled in the Grand Scapular by any Catholic priest in order to gain all of the privileges and indulgences and to share all of the good works and prayers of all Carmelite priests, nuns, and Third Order members. Once you are enrolled in the Scapular, you never need to be enrolled in it again. It is for life. You don't even have to continually get new scapulars blessed. It carries over with the enrollment. All of the saints and many holy people were scapular wearers, including St. John Paul II, who was a Third Order Carmelite. He gave an address to youth in the year 1989, and St. John Paul told them, "Be vigilant to correspond to your good mother, who is concerned about how you go about dressed, especially with respect to the garment of grace that her daughters and sons should always wear." The Grand Scapular is one of the greatest sacramentals we have in the Church. Volumes and chapters of miracles attributed to the Grand Scapular have been written. When we wear that Grand Scapular over our shoulders, with one part hanging in front and the other in back, we are to visualize our Blessed Mother's arms lovingly embracing us, protecting us from harm. keeping us away from all of the enticements of sin. We must realize that we are always under her watchful vigilance. When you are in spiritual or physical danger, hold on to your scapular and whisper a prayer to Our Lady for help. When you are tempted to sin, touch your scapular and beg God to keep you from offending Him. Kiss your scapular often as a sign of your consecration to Our Lady. Pray an ejaculation frequently to Our Lady of Mount Carmel. And never take the scapular off. You should even sleep with it on, as none of us knows the day or the hour of our death. And as our Blessed Lord bids us in the Holy Gospels, we must always be prepared for death, and the best way is through the wearing of the Holy Scapular. I will never forget about 11 years ago, when I was assigned to Staten Island, the parish had care of a nursing home, and it was a Saturday morning about 8 o'clock, and I received a call in my room that there was someone dying at that nursing home in need of the last rites. And so I went immediately, and I walked into the room, and it hit me like a ton of bricks. There was a piece of white typing paper above the bed of the woman, and in black magic marker it said, "Under no circumstances is the brown scapular to be removed from Mrs. So-and-so." And her daughter was there. I gave her the extra motion, the apostolic pardon, the indulgence at the hour of death. And after concluding all of that, I said to the daughter, "You did a great service for your mother, and of course, calling for the priest for the last rites, but also in putting that sign above the bed." And she said to me, "Father, my mother was very devoted to the brown scapular. She wore it daily and prayed the rosary daily." So I left, and I went back to the rectory, and about 12 o'clock noon, I got another phone call that the mother had died. It was a Saturday, the Sabbath time privilege. God is never outdone in generosity. Our Blessed Mother's request to wear the scapular deplorably is ignored by many Catholics. And worse yet, many are ignoring this request and shutting away all of these indulgences and graces that come with the wearing of the burnt scapular. May we do our own small part in spreading devotion to Our Blessed Lady under the title of Our Lady of Mount Carmel, and make known to all of those we come in contact with the efficacy of this sacrament. None of us is too great to wear the brown scapular. We may be the most intelligent of people, we may be the most sophisticated of people, but we are childlike, we are children in the eyes of God. There should not be one person in this church tonight who is not wearing the brown scapular of Our Lady of Mount Carmel. Again, St. Jose Maria Escriva wrote, "Wear on your breast the holy scapular of Mount Carmel. There are many excellent Marian devotions, but few are as deep-rooted among the faithful and so